Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. Apostle Paul was talking about how the serpent beguiled Eve, how the serpent deceived Eve into believing a lie, and how it is very easy for people to, as a result of the simplicity that is in Christ, craft people into believing a lie. Now, there are several things that we need to consider in this particular piece. The simplicity that is in Christ talks about our simple obedience to Christ. So when you find yourself under the leadership of a man of God, or you find yourself under the leadership of a shepherd, you have to be able to draw the line between your simple obedience to Christ and your simple obedience to man. The Bible told us in 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 13 that we should become subject to powers, we should become subject to governors. But it does not mean that we should become subject to governance if that governance runs contrary to what the Bible says. That is where we need to draw a line. The fact that somebody has become a papa in the Lord, the fact that somebody has become a father in the Lord, does not give that person the right to overrule the intent of the Word of God. And that is why there is a need for each and every one of us to have a perfect understanding of what the Word of God is all about. Sadly enough, a whole lot of us live our life just like a buffalo. The head buffalo leaves the other trail of buffalo. And if that head buffalo end up in the ditch, every of those buffalo, they follow suit. Now, we are not going to continue to live our life like a buffalo, because if the fall of a man of God will not determine my own fall, and should not determine what you follow, will definitely have an impact in your life. If you follow a particular man of God who says that masturbation is okay, then you can end up one day masturbating, running contrary to the will of God. But one thing I just want us to have at the back of our mind is that we are running an individual race. No man is going to stand for me, no man is going to stand for you. So we have to be self-sufficient when it comes to spirituality. I am not saying that you might not have the need to go to somebody who might be higher above you spiritually to seek for counsel. But what I'm saying is that for you to remain an empty dumpty is a crime. And how do you do it? The only way not to remain an empty dumpty is to be conversant with what the Word of God is saying about every other topic. There are millions of topics treated by the Word of God. In fact, there are no other topics that you can find outside the Word of God in existence, because the Bible has taken care of every other yearning questions that may arise in our mind. The most important thing, and what I'm so much particular about, is the knowledge of the Word of God. We have to develop ourselves. We have to go a little bit further into learning what the Word of God says, what the Word of God wants, what God desires of us. Everything is embedded in His Word. And as you do that, the Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. All I just want you to do is to read and ask for understanding. That is all you need. And the Lord will bless you. I want to encourage you to share this video with others who might be interested in watching, or you can follow us on our Facebook page. The Lord will bless you as you do that in the mighty name of Jesus.